See, most people forgot about the Rubik's Cube back in the 80s, so it had its heyday and then disappeared. The mathematicians remained obsessed with it.
They wanted to find out the number of moves it would take to solve the most difficult combination.
People probably are aware that there is some maths involved in a Rubik's Cube, and the group is the number of different combinations that there are on the Rubik's Cube. It's all the different ways that you can scramble up a cube.
Other things do have permutations and symmetry, but there's just something nice and tactile, and you can grab it and you can see everything as it happens.
And this number would be called God's number. If you had perfect knowledge of how to do the Rubik's Cube, you would be able to solve the most difficult position in its perfect, most efficient algorithm. They managed to work out that it was less than 30. And over the years, they started to whittle this down closer and closer.
No matter how much you scramble up a Rubik's Cube, you can solve it in 20 or fewer twists. And it's called God's number because you'd have to be some kind of omniscient being to work out those 20 moves. It's so difficult to calculate what those moves are.
I mean, I couldn't look at a cube and say, oh, I need to do these 12 moves or whatever. But there are people who can. So they do Rubik's Cube solving competitions, and they have obviously speed challenges and so you can solve it the fastest. But one of the other things that they do is a kind of efficient solve. And the competition there is look at a Rubik's Cube and then just write down a list of moves that will solve it, which I think is probably more impressive than people who can solve it really quickly.
It was called the super flip. Now the super flip is essentially completely solved, except each edge position was flipped over. If you take one of those pieces off and turn it around, you get a whole new universe. You can't get back to the solved Rubik's Cube if you do that. (4.3 × 10⁻¹⁹). It's a massive number, though. It's a massive number of combinations.
It's 43,252,003,374,489,856,000. It's a mind-numbing number of possible arrangements.
So this was a big craze in the 1980s, big craze. In the 1880s, exactly 100 years earlier, there was a similar puzzle that was also a big craze.
They had their code that checked the reduced number of cases. They ran it on the Google servers, and they exhaustively checked. And we know now for a fact
that God's number is 20. Every Rubik's puzzle can be solved in 20 or fewer moves.
You might might think, well, how do we know? How do we know that? Did we just check all 43.25 billion billion different ways of solving it? And we effectively did that.
And there are 12 factorial ways to arrange the edges.